In this video, we'll discuss how to set up a title block and update that title block in a new drawing. To start with, I will first choose this new drawing button from the project manager to create a new drawing in this active project. I will enter the new drawing name as practice_title_block. Next, I need to select the template for this drawing. I want to select the template that we have created in the last video as a template for this drawing. So I will choose the browse button over here, and in this template folder, which is displayed in this select template dialog box, I will select this new template one which we have created in the last video. Now I will choose the open button. Next, in the sheet values area, I can enter sheet number. This is because we have defined this attribute in the title block, so we need to enter the sheet value here. Suppose I enter the sheet value as T1. Next, I need to also specify the drawing value in this drawing edit box. Suppose I enter it as 101. Next, I'll choose the OK button. Now the apply project defaults to drawings message box is displayed. I will choose yes in this message box. And now you can see this practice title block drawing is created with the new template. Also, this AutoCAD message box is displayed where it is mentioned that no .wdt file or wd_tb attribute form, and it is also specified that you need to run the AutoCAD electrical title block setup wizard. So I will just choose the OK button here. Now, to set up a title block, I need to choose the title block setup tool. For that, I will go to this project tab, and then in this other tools panel, I will choose this title block setup tool. On choosing this tool, you can see the setup title block update dialog box is displayed. You can see here in this dialog box, number of radio buttons are there, where this project.wdt file radio button is selected. We want to use this project.wdt file for setting up the title block, so we'll just keep this radio button selected. If you want to use this default.wdt file for setting up the title block, then you can select this. And if you want to use the second method for setting up the title block, you can select this radio button. We'll keep this default option as it is, and we'll choose the OK button over here. Now the enter block name dialog box is displayed. In this dialog box, you can enter the block name in this edit box. You can use the active drawing as the block by choosing this button, or you can pick the block from the active drawing also. So I will choose this pick block button, and I will select this block and press enter. Now this block name for this template block is specified here, which we have named while creating the block in the last video. You might remember that. So now I will choose the OK button over here. Next, this title block setup dialog box is displayed, where this project.wdt file's location is specified. And in this dialog box, I need to specify the respective attributes for this Linux values. You might remember that while discussing the WDL file, we have renamed the Linux values for the descriptions, and those values are now displayed over here. Next, we'll assign attributes to the project values one by one. First, I'll assign attribute for this title one project value. I'll assign project name for this project value. Then I will go to this engineer project value, and I will assign this attribute. Next, drn by for drawn by, chk by for checked by, then scale for this scale project value, I think now project values attributes are over. Now I will choose this drawing values button to assign the drawing attributes to the drawing values. For this first drawing value, I will select this DRG number attribute. Then I will go to this full file name and assign this file name attribute. Next, I will go to this sheet drawing value and assign this sheet attribute. Now I think all the attributes are assigned to the respective project or drawing values. Now I can choose the OK button in this title block setup dialog box. Now we need to update the title block. For that, make sure you are in the project tab, and then in this other tools panel, go to this title block update tool. And here, now you can see all these title block values which we have set up using the title block setup tool are displayed here. Now I need to select the checkboxes as per my template created. So in my template, this title one is there, then engineer, then drawn by, checked by, scale, then full file name, drawing value, and then sheet value. So these are the attributes which we have defined in our template. So I have selected these attributes. Now we have two options. We can update the title block for all the drawings or selected drawings in the project, or I can update the title block for the active drawing only. Right now we have used this new template for this active drawing only, so I will just update the title block for this drawing. So I will choose the OK active drawing only button. On choosing this button, you can see this title block is updated with all the respective attributes displayed here. You can see this full file name is also displayed. Only thing is that this CADSIM attribute is a little bit shifted to left, which should have been in the center of this box. So to correct it, I can do one thing. I can go to this new project. I will right click and I'll choose the descriptions option. And here for this CADSIM, if I write project, then I think this will be corrected. So if I choose the OK button. But now to reflect this description in this title block, I need to again update this title block with this tool. And this time now I will only update this title one description because I have updated all other attributes. Now I can choose the OK active drawing only button. And here you can see this CADSIM project is now at the center. So this way you can update the title blocks as many times as you change the descriptions or you change any of the attributes. So that's all in this video. Thanks for watching.